Okay, dear students, once again welcome to this class, and I want to spend some time requesting you to write three essays.
Kashmir, unmute.
Three essays. Please, can any one of you unmute yourself and tell me a topic that you want to write on? Or either you tell me or you write on your chat. Any one topic. Any one topic. Can you please unmute yourself and tell me, or you just write on the chat. Any one topic or any one theme that you are interested in. Hello. Hello, is there anything that you want to know more? Are you all there? Please unmute yourself. Theme or question?
Other life after death.
We have done it. Life after death. Okay. Now I am taking you to the whiteboard. This is what I would like you to do for yourself on this topic of life after death or any other thing. So let us just take, I am taking you to the whiteboard. I hope you can all see it. Therefore, first thing, I will write the topic. Life okay, then here you got to write your name, but that, those the details will come later. Yes, now first there would be an introduction, and in the introduction you are going to say something about life after death and the difficulties and the challenges and the hopes about it. Therefore, that you are going to add later. As you know, introduction is the last thing that you write when you write an essay. So now, after having reflected on it and then problems connected with this life after death, I will start with life as an intricate mystery. That could be the subtitle number one. Then the subtitle number two could be longing for more. More than life. Then I have the something reflections on death and beyond. And fourth one. Yes. Religious convictions and experiences. Fifth one could be proofs for and against life after death. Sixth one, my personal take. And seventh one could be the introduction. Normally, we don't give a number to the conclusion. What happens is the number seven, I cannot show you. Therefore, five and six, I'm going to take the five and six here. Proofs, four Then sixth, my personal take. Conclusion. Okay. I am just giving you a broad outline. Now, as you develop this, I may change this. I may change the title, change actually the structure. But at least I have something to go by. First point, let us take the first point. Life as an intricate mystery. Now, after having read all these things, reflected on, let us elaborate that aspect, life as an intricate mystery. Here some sub points, some quotations, some insights you can write. For example, what is a mystery according to Marcel? Is not a problem. That is one aspect. In life, there are so many unknowable things. And you can quote Heidegger and say, we are being unto death. And in this COVID situation, we know more than 6 lakhs people are dead. Tragic. But for a philosopher, one death is equal to any other death. Of course, we are scared when so many people die, but the death of 5 lakhs may be as significant or as insignificant as the death of one person. Now, given the uncertainty, given the whole tragedy of life, we need to ask ourselves the question, what is life? And the answer somehow is connected to death. Death is somehow part of the solution that we are going to bring in. And then you can actually have a few more quotations. A few more quotations on life and death. The goal of philosophy is learning how to die. And Maurice would say, you can only relish your life if you know how to die. So these are some of the quotations that you get. So in part number one, please make some subsections, some points and other kind of things so that you can actually argue for the next. And the next one, of course, is longing for more. So let me again do something similar with the second point. For more. First thing, we always need more things, persons, money, and somehow that is connected with the magis. Even at the spiritual level, we need more. So it is very natural that we need more of life. Now, this more of life is something in terms of time, but not just in terms of time in the sense of temporal immortality. That is not the only thing that we long for. We long for quality of life, intensity of our relation. And then we also long for a life after death. Particularly when we see innocent lives are stolen. You know, so many innocent lives are taken away. It could be due to abortion. It could be during murder. It could be also. So when we see this kind of discrepancies in life, we see that there. Yes, anyone wants to contribute something? Hello? Hello? Okay. I am continuing. So, what I would really wish that you see is, based on your readings, based on your reflections, draw a general outline.
Father, somebody has unmuted the mic, so there is noise.
Okay. You have unmuted. That's okay. Let me check. Is it okay now? Hello? Okay. So now we are come to point number one, point number two. Please do the same thing for all these points. First, jot down your points, main headings, then the subheadings, some books, some insights. But the aim of your essay should be you have to argue something. At the end of your life, of your essay, you must say what you really want to say to the audience. My personal take. After having analyzed the intricate mystery that life is, there is a longing for more in life, the magic. Death, a frightening scenario, but he says something more to death. There are also some experiences. Then we speak about the religious convictions, the Christian conviction, the Hindu, Jainism, the reincarnation, and so on. And for proofs for, we can talk about the extrinsic dependency of Aquinas, the many people who claim to have come back to life. Proof against would be those people, for example, the Charvakas, who would say life comes to an end with death. Eat, drink, and make merry. There is nothing more. So, after having analyzed all these things, we can come to a conclusion that most probably there is a life after death. Immanuel Kant calls that as a hypothesis. He would say, there is no justice in this world. There are many people who are holy and who are innocent, but they suffer. And in order to make sense of this life on earth, we have at least to postulate immortality. So for Kant, it's a question of not proving, but postulate, imagine. Then after having done all these things, write in different paragraphs. See that there is a connection between one paragraph and another. And then you, if you feel the need, you can change all these sections. Maybe you find that life has intricate mysteries too much. Therefore, you just say, life has a meaningful mystery. Or life as something of an ongoing process. You can change that. The third one, death and beyond, maybe you think it is too much. You can include the death and mystery in the second one, longing for more, and then you delete it. So, initial outline, you will change in the course of your time. What you really need is just spend some time. Read a few books. I don't want you to read more than four or five books, some internet sources. And then at the end of it, you make your personal argument. Here the question is, you have to argue your case. If you really want, you can also argue against life after death. Given all the uncertainties, intricacies, I tend to believe that there is nothing more. And even if there is nothing more after our death, our life would be meaningful. Then you have the conclusion. And in the conclusion, you will have to sum up what you have been saying. Come with your main point and then end it. And after writing the conclusion, come back to introduction. Start with a nice quote. See, when you write the introduction, it is better to start with one nice quotation or a story or an event. So these things will capture your attention. Then you explain what is the question that you are asking. And then you have to say, what is the method that you employ? Method. Then also you have to say, who is the audience? The limitations of your research. Finally, indirectly, you have to say, what is the new thing that you want the reader to get? So what is the new thing? That's all part of the introduction. This introduction you write actually at the very end. So that is how I want you to write the essay. It is not a big essay I am expecting. I only want you to write 1,000 words. It could be up a little more, little less, doesn't matter. 1,000 words. Just refer to the notes. The notes that we are there, yes, refer to that. Also refer to the other books that I have suggested to you, the novels, the logotherapy and other books you can refer. Also refer to the internet, but see that your reference is not only the internet. Okay, given this, I want to show one model, and that model is written by one of your own seniors, someone who was here last year. I'll just go through that so that you have an idea of how this essay has to be written. Actually, if it is for me, one essay would take about 2 hours to write. To read a little bit and then to come some kind of a conclusion, explain that conclusion. And in your case, you know, it may take a little more time, but I wanted to do this for two reasons. One, this will help you to understand, to do your seminar paper better, very much better. Second, when you give a homily, when you address the students in your assembly, maybe during your regency, this is the method that I would like you to follow. Just brief introduction, then some points and sub-points, come to a conclusion. You know, there are some people who are so much possessed of the stories that they don't know how to end their talk. And that would be very, very, very poor performance from the point of view of the students. Okay, now, dear friends, I'm just showing you an article, an essay which I would like. This essay, which I'm going to show, is slightly larger, but basically it contains everything that I really mean it. Therefore, let us look at this model article. Here you have the article. I hope all of you can see it. Now on the left side, because I have chosen the, on the view, you see the navigation pane on the view, I can actually get the structure of it. So let me stay with you. I'll take you right from the beginning. This is the title, Being Human in the Age of Life 3.0. Then This is the subtitle, Challenges of Technological Evolution for Humanity. It is not absolutely necessary, but it is good to have a title and a subtitle. Then you have the name of the author and you have the designation. You can write BPH, third BPH, Gyanadev Vidyapeeth, Pune, or your house and other kind of things you can write. Okay, that is the basic thing. But remember, you will be changing all these things. Initially, you might have started with one title, but then as you work out, the title and the subtitles could change. There is an abstract and there is a keyword. This one, you do it, but at the very end. Abstract is the summary of what you're writing. This abstract, you normally take from the introduction and from the conclusion, the abstract. The bring together the introduction and conclusion, reduce it. The abstract really tells you, for most people, they are not interested in reading your article, but they want to know a summary of what you have written. That is abstract. And then you have the keywords. What are the main words that you use? Like life after death, karma, reincarnation, resurrection. These would be some of the keywords that you have used. Now, these keywords should be there already. Okay. You have the introduction, which I said is written at the very end. He talks about Techmark and his book. And welcome to the most important conversation of our time. Yeah, that is how he begins. And it's a catchy phrase. Then you have actually the subsections from carbon to silicon-based evolution. It is very good, dear brothers, if you can, only if you can, go to the home and use the heading number, headings. This is heading number 2. It is better to use the heading number 2 or 3. So this is heading number 3, from carbon to silicon-based evolution. And you have actually an insight quotation. A quotation, an insight quote. So this is actually the quote of Minsky. Minsky is the surname of the author. And then you have actually the year. Again, this quote is taken. Minsky is the author and the year of the book. Second subtitle, Techmark is the author and the year of the book. If there is a page number, you can also give, for example, Maurice 1999, page 35. That if you want, you can give if you are sure of the page number. Then some quotations, some footnotes you can have, but these are descriptive footnotes. Don't give the name of the author and things of that sort here. The name of the author and other things will be coming in the text itself. And then you are arguing your case, transportation and healthcare sectors, and how artificial intelligence is useful for us. Concluding remarks. Instead of the conclusion, you have written the concluding remarks. Yuval Harari, in his book, 21 Lessons for 21st Century, shares the possibility of the book name should always be in italics. And then there is actually a footnote. Bibliography, this is the crucial thing. Whatever books you have brought in here, for example, Harari 2018, that should be here. Harari, Yuval Noah, 2018. Techmark was there, Techmark this. So have some 4 or 5 bibliography, and then it is good for you to add about the author. There on top, you have only given your designation, third BPH Gyanadev Vidyapeeth. But at the end, something like about the author. He's a student of theology at Gyanadev, he belongs to the zone. And then this is for your reference. This is not part of the essay. The summary of your main argument in 2 for essays. This essay gives the glimpse of possible dangers of technological evolution and brings out the questions to be addressed in such a situation. This is what the essay attempts: the possible dangers of technological evolution and what are some of the questions that we need to address. So once again, a title, subtitle, your name and your designation, then introduction, first point, second point, third point. But these subsections, you can go to any number, no problem, 3, 4, 5. A few quotations which are descriptive. A few footnotes which are descriptive. Concluding remarks, bibliography. Now my request to you is, I have sent you this model article that is there in your Google Classroom. I have also given you about 80 questions. Now you choose any three questions. It need not be from those 80 questions, but it could be based on those three questions. You choose any three questions which you think are important for your course on a human person. After having gone through those 80 questions, most of you have gone through all those questions, but you know, each question you elaborated into a paragraph of 4 or 5 sentences. Now again, please read through the whole notes, personalize something out of it, and then choose 3 questions. Choose 3 topics for your essay. Now, I would be happy if you are creative enough and choose different topics than what are given there. You can, for example, choose any one of those topics also. For example, there I have given the question, an idea is more practical, a good theory is more practical than anything else. That is something connected with philosophy, with our thinking, with our imagination, with our dream. That is something you can take on. Now, first you choose 3 topics. Don't start writing. After having chosen, go to the net, maybe a few good net sources. Most of the sources from the net are useless. Therefore, don't rely on, you know, false or spurious net sources. Rely only on sources which you can count on. Then you read also a few books. The basic that I wanted to read would be Our Own Notes, the short version of it. If you want, you can also read the longer version which we have uploaded in the classroom. Then after that, read the books that I have uploaded. They are very important. You know, there are also some other books and novels which I have uploaded on another Google Classroom called the Books. So you can also go through the other classrooms. For example, I have another Google Classroom which is called Books for Reading. So in this Books for Reading classwork, I have given you so many books, but these are small books, so you don't need to worry too much about it. But what I want you to do is, I will just show you that Google Classroom book. Most of you have entered into this Google Classroom. Little Prince, There Will Come Soft Rains, Alice in the Wonderland, Gulliver's Travel, To Kill the Mockingbird. These are already given in the material, is already given in Google Classroom. And I have also sent the soft copy to your email ID. So you can read this. And if you want to enter into this, the class code is 4SHC. I'm copying it. And I am actually sending it to your present classroom, philosophical anthropology, and let me go to philosophical anthropology. There I am sending you the classroom for books. Okay, now let me come back. Do you have any questions or any suggestions? You can ask me in chat. Yes.
You spoke first. You spoke about the assignment. Writing the assignment on one question. Life after death. That is an example.
Yeah.
So after that, you spoke about selecting three questions. I didn't get it. Is it a continuation of the same assignment or separate assignment?
See, actually, this is not an assignment. This is actually your final exam. See, you are supposed to have the final exam starting from August 17th. So instead of the final assignment, this is not the assignment for our class, but this is the final exam for the class. So the final exam, what I would like is write one file, just one file, consisting of three essays. And what I have shown you is a model for one of the essays. The topic for the essays could be anyone from the 80 questions or modification from those 80 questions. Or it could be something of your own based on our classes.
Okay, Father, that means we have to write on three questions, the same method we have to follow. Consisting of 1,000 words.
Yeah.
Each question or the entire thing?
Each question. Otherwise, it would be only 350 that you can.
Okay. That means 1,000 words.
And then follow the same thing. What I want is maybe you can take a few more words. Because I wanted to write the abstract, the index, about the author and all these kind of things. Because this is how, you know, academic essays are written. And exactly this is how your seminar paper also should be written. Now, the difference is in a seminar paper, you don't write the abstract and the keywords. That's because it is much longer. Seminar paper is something like a book. In a book, you don't write abstract and keywords. But when you're writing an article, you write abstract and keywords. But that's not very important. Abstract is the summary, the basic insight that you are gaining from your paper. Yes?
Okay.
So, Father Guru, today is the last class.
Hello?
Yes.
The date of today?
No, today is today the last class. You are going to leave us free from today to write the assignment.
I am not leaving you free, but basically I will be leaving you free because I want to accompany you in writing the paper. Therefore, I'll be calling you tomorrow, for example. Tomorrow, is it my class or this fellow's our? Tomorrow is yours,
Father.
Okay. So tomorrow, what I would like you to do is think of these topics. I want you to come and at least spend 15 minutes because if I leave you totally free, then you everything will go on. See, I want you to come, have a focused work, the choice of the topic, and then writing on that. So basically what you're saying is true. Get it correct. I don't have any more materials to give you. So in that sense, today is last class. But I want you to take seriously these three essays. Therefore, I'll be with you, accompanying you. Did you understand? The last class in terms of contents is today. But I will be taking class. Maybe, okay, let me do it this way. Tomorrow we will not have class. Okay, tomorrow we will not have class. But day after tomorrow we will come. You come prepared with the, at least with the three essays, the themes. Is it okay?
Father, tomorrow, no. Day after tomorrow is Saturday, no?
Oh, day after tomorrow is Saturday.
Yes, Father.
Yes, Father.
Okay, my God. Okay.
You mean on Monday?
Come on Monday.
Father. We have only three more classes. Okay. So we come back on Monday, on 10th August. Okay. But meanwhile, you prepare the, choose the three topics and have some subsections and points with it. Have a look at the model article that they have given you. You don't need to read the content of the article. That is not important. But only the structure is important. Then read through the whole short notes fully and come with the three choices that you have, that you are choosing. And I hope that all of you will not choose just one of you. Please, some of you choose the harder
choices.
Hello? Hello? Okay. Tomorrow then.
Father?
Yes?
Instead of writing three topics, can we write one single topic, 3,000 words? It would be easier. No, Father? We can write longer.
Just for only one topic,
one
please.
One
topic for 3,000 words.
No, just 1,000.
See what happens.
No, one topic, please. One topic, please.
I have no problem. I can give you the if you want to write. If you want to write one of 3,000, I have no difficulty. But I can warn you that is much more difficult, because 3,000 words. Please don't copy paste from the internet. To get 3,000 words of your own is much more difficult than to get 1,000 of this one. 1,000 could mean up to 1,500. So if you are really serious about it, take a topic. I have no difficulty. But please let me know beforehand which topic you are taking. Don't take a very too general topic, okay? The topics should not be too general that, it should be a little focused, little detailed. You cannot take, for example, a topic like the summary of the book. No, that is not what we want. If you want to take one, you're most welcome. But let me know.
Okay, Father, thank you.
So we are not meeting tomorrow. Instead, we will meet on Monday. By that time, go through that model article. Go through that my short notes. My short notes. Notes means that 70, 80 pages. And if possible, after having finalized your topic, also send me the, come with actually the subtopics. Those of you who are doing seminar paper with me, we will meet 9:30 tomorrow. I hope some of you are there. I will send the invitation also. Those of you who are doing seminar paper tomorrow, we will meet, not at 9:10, but 11:10 we will meet. 11:10. Those of you who are doing seminar paper with me.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you. Things are clear, no? Therefore, one thing, you don't have a final exam for this course. I would be calculating all your assignments and things of that sort. And then this would be the final paper.
For tomorrow, what class you said?
Once again?
Tomorrow, what class you have
tomorrow,
said?
No. Tomorrow, there will be just a session for about 10 of you have taken me as the seminar guide. So there will be the class only for those seminar students, BPS seminar students. Okay. I am planning going to do something else, but I don't want any one of you to feel bad. I am going to read out the names of some people who have not submitted the assignments. Is it okay? I want you to submit them, though it is a little late.
Okay, brother.
Because you may not be even there. The point is, I'm telling you everyone so that if you know your friends have missed it, please inform them. So I'm reading out some names, okay?
Please. Joseph.
Hello.
Father, that Joseph George, I don't know.
Father, please mute all and then Father, please meet all.
Okay, so I am going to read out the names of some people who have not submitted the assignments. Please tell them to submit it if they are your friends. One, Alan K. Shaji. Two, Albester Kujur. Anand Raj M. Anjay Sess. Anup Kumar Ba. Arul L. Reetness. Arul Simon did not submit two, but that's okay. Then Ashwin Tigger.
Hey, Kumare.
Yes?
Joseph George, please remove him from the class, Father. I don't know who is he.
Joseph George?
Who is he? He is disturbing the whole class. Please remove him.
Hello. Hello. Can you, Joseph George? Are you there? Okay, you are there. Please mute yourself. Okay, now the other names. Bidwan, one, that's okay. James Eka, please. James Eka. Joby S. Joby S is from Bethany, no? Then Joseph George KX. Manish Tiga. Angami. Prakash Digal. Ratnagar Singh. Sahaya Anish. Okay, so these names, if you know them, I will be sending a mail to them. But you know, the problem is they may not even check the JDB email. So if you can contact them, tell them to submit the assignments which are due. Tell them how to get into the Google account and submit the assignments. I will be sending a reminder just now to them. That's okay.
The one is discontinued, Father.
Which, who is the one discontinued, you know? Name?
Anand, first in the beginning.
Anand Raj M.
Yes, Father.
Oh. Where was he from? Which house?
Madurai.
DNC. Oh, Madurai just. DNC. Yeah. Then it's okay, what to do. But you know, this fellow is telling, even if he has, but it will be too late. Even if he has discontinued, has he got a job or something?
No.
Tell him if possible. I'm saying Hello. If possible, tell him to continue and get a BPH and go, because you know a BPH will be valuable, especially when you go to the corporate world. BPH has got a value, but I mean it depends on him. But tell him if possible, do the online courses and complete the course.
Hello, Father.
Yeah.
Father, I am Ratnakar. I have sent everything, Father. All the assignment I have submitted to you.
Ratnakar, let me check here.
Yeah. Which assignment have not come? Mm-hmm.
Did you send it to me by email or how did you send it?
I sent to you.
Personally, to my email ID. Then it's okay. I have not incorporated that. See, what is missing is a first week classroom notes. See, I am looking at the
photocopy. No, you photocopy, no, Father.
Yeah.
That I sent after that I sent to you because okay. We had little problem with that.
Yeah. Then it's okay. You just I will look into it. Okay. No problem.
Okay, Father.
Did you write the short answers?
Everything I wrote.
Okay.
Okay, what do you do? All okay, the Hello.
Hello.
Yeah. Hey, Stanley. No, no problem. No problem. We've been Stanley. Hey, Vicky Lal is missing the short questions. Vicky Lal is there, no? Hello, Vicky. Okay, no problem. Okay, so hey. Tomorrow no class. Monday we meet. And when we meet, you know what to do. Choose your three topics. And if these topics, please don't do, just copy from the 80 questions that I gave you. Something unique, something that you want to tell us, share with us. Today, many people have not come. The maximum is 40. Therefore, it's a bit of a problem. Tell them to watch the video, which I would be uploading.
Father, some just...